I'm Chad Topaz, and I'm at Williams College and Institute for the Quantitative Study of Inclusion, Diversity, and Equity. When I was young, I would say that math came somewhat naturally to me, but I would also say that I worked very hard at it, and I had many other interests that were equally as pressing for me as mathematics was. The question, when did I know I wanted to become a mathematician? I'm still not 100% sure, is my most honest answer. I mean, I really love what I do. And I think the thing I appreciated about it the most, especially as an applied mathematician and data scientist, is the way I can use mathematical tools to engage with all sorts of other areas that interest me equally as much. So I began my mathematical career as an applied mathematician and mathematical modeler. And so what mathematical modeling means is sort of taking things in the real world and trying to translate them into a mathematical framework so that we can use mathematical tools to study them. And in particular, the kinds of things I was studying were things in nature that form patterns. So I worked on the formation of waves on the surfaces of fluids, so doing a little fluid physics. I worked on formation of patterns in chemical reaction systems. And I spent a long time working on formation of patterns in biology. So working on things like fish schools and bird flocks and insect swarms and trying to understand why those groups form and what they do. Over time, my interest drifted a little bit, and I stopped doing quite so much mathematical modeling and use of tools from differential equations and scientific computing, and I drifted a bit more into data science. So these days, I'm very concerned with studying big, complicated data sets, still doing some of that work in biology, but a lot focused on issues of social justice. And I'm using tools from traditional statistics and also a newer field called topological data analysis. I've had struggles really in my career on a couple of axes. One is just that I think I matured rather late in terms of my approach to learning. And so I mean, academically, when I was an undergraduate student, I was not the strongest undergraduate student. And even at the for the first couple of years of my PhD program, I would say I was maybe not the strongest PhD student. So I had my own sort of journey of learning how to learn that I had to do. I've also had some struggles related to sort of personal identity issues. So I'm a gay man. I came out in 1994-ish when I was maybe 93, when I was around sophomore year of college. And, I've had job offers rescinded. I've been yelled at in the street when walking with my husband. We've faced a fair amount of discrimination and harassment. And that's been hard because if my desire was to work as a teacher and a researcher in academia, and it was, like we had to make a lot of decisions about our professional lives simply based on, where it was safe for us and where we could be recognized as a married couple, where we would be allowed to adopt a child, and all of these sorts of things. It's been very sobering to think that we got past some of those challenges thanks to changes in our laws, Supreme Court decisions, and so forth, and realize that, like, actually, no, we're not past all of those challenges. And I'm realizing once again that I need to be sort of thinking about my safety and my family's rights and where we go. And it's a bummer to have to think about that when what you want to be doing is teaching and doing research. We all have our challenges and struggles, and that one is mine. It's a funny thing being asked to share your proudest accomplishments because I do think there's a thing in academia where many of us get a message that we're not, like, not good enough or need to do more or be more. So it feels very like humbling and awkward to be asked this question. I'm the co-founder of a nonprofit institute called Institute for the Quantitative Study of Inclusion, Diversity, and Equity. I never envisioned myself as an entrepreneurial person or someone who would co-found a nonprofit, but at that institute, we use mathematics and data science and computation to try to promote social justice. And I am very proud of what we have been able to do there, even though there's a lot of work to be done. I'm also, I don't know if it's an accomplishment. I feel privileged to have been able to do the work that I've done with students. Like, I have been very fortunate to have really amazing students who want to collaborate on things and do research together. And again, I don't know if pride is the right word, but it makes me really happy. Like, that is a thing that happened makes me very happy. Yeah. I've been really fortunate to have wonderful mentors. So when I was a PhD student at Northwestern, my advisor was Mary Silber, who really was and continues to be a role model for me. And I had a postdoc with Andrea Bertozzi, and Andrea was a wonderful mentor who taught me a lot about specific areas of math and also research and the research process. Andy Burnoff at Harvey Mudd College is a longtime research collaborator of mine. And I learned so very much of what I know about doing research with students from Andy. My colleague at Williams, Pamela Harris, is absolutely one of my heroes and is a role model to me in terms of how to do everything professional. And then also someone who I've only met once briefly in real life, but is a huge influence on me, is Piper H, who's currently at Toronto now. Piper has taught me probably the very most important lesson of my entire professional life, which is that before anything else, students are humans. And that's a message that I find myself returning to all the time. So yeah, those are just a few of the people I have been fortunate to be influenced by. This might sound overenthusiastic, but I believe in my heart that anyone can do math, anyone has the capacity to do math. What we need is a system that includes and fosters that in everyone, but everyone can do math. And moreover, I think math can actually change the world. And so I think it's like an amazing knowing some math and putting it towards forces of good is an amazing thing that anyone is capable of doing if they want to.